Are your logs eating up your budget?
What if you could keep only what matters without losing visibility? In this video, we're unpacking Datadog's Logging Without Limits, a strategy that helps you scale logging without scaling costs. I'll show you the mindset, the setup, and even a live demo at the end. Let's go! When you're developing locally, it makes sense to log everything. Errors, infos, debugs. You want full visibility to understand what's going on. But when you scale to hundreds or thousands of servers, with tens of thousands of users, that flood of logs becomes a liability. It's not just overwhelming, it's expensive. Datadog's Logging Without Limits flips traditional logging on its head. Instead of indexing every log line, you assign value to logs and make decisions based on that value. High-value logs? You index and keep them longer. Low-value logs? You might not index them at all, or keep them for just a short time. Let's break it down with a common setup. Error logs, critical. Keep them indexed for 15 days. They show failure trends and help trace issues. Info logs, useful but less critical. Retain them for 3 to 7 days. Debug logs, valuable in dev but noisy in prod. Often best to discard or exclude them from indexing. By adjusting retention based on log type, you dramatically reduce cost without losing operational insights, and with that you have the first level of strategy you can apply with Logging Without Limits. Now let's talk about one of Datadog's most underrated features, LiveTail. It gives you real-time access to every incoming log, no indexing needed. Here's the trick. Datadog automatically makes all logs available in LiveTail for 15 minutes after ingestion. So what's the point? You're in the middle of a deployment, LiveTail lets you watch it live. No filters, no delay. A major incident hits. Even if debug logs aren't indexed, you can still catch them as they stream in. You don't want to index everything, but still want to see everything when it matters? LiveTail's your best friend. Let's be honest, when something's broken, it's usually broken now. Those first 15 minutes are where the gold is. LiveTail gives you that visibility instantly. First, stop the pipeline. In the last video, we sent our logs from the instances through these pipelines for processing and analysis, and enriched them with attributes and metadata. Now they've arrived at this specific point in the platform. As you can see, each is independent, configured separately, and not reliant on the others. The first destination for your logs, after passing through the earlier steps, is LiveTail. LiveTail shows everything coming into the platform in real time. It's like running a tail F on every log stream. Here you'll see logs flowing in by the second. Volume depends on your traffic. Want to narrow things down? You can filter for anything, just like anywhere else in Datadog. For example, I can view only logs coming from Vector, right here in LiveTail. Think of LiveTail as your go-to for real-time troubleshooting. No indexing needed, this is pure live data. It's ideal during new deployments. You can instantly see what's happening. Or when testing a change, it helps spot debug logs you normally wouldn't index. That's exactly what LiveTail is built for. All right, so we just covered LiveTail, which gives you that immediate real-time view of incoming logs. But what if you need to dig into something that happened yesterday or 2 weeks ago? That's where indexing comes in. Indexing is how you tell Datadog, hey, these logs matter. Keep them searchable for longer. You can choose to retain logs for as little as 3 days or as much as 90 days, depending on your needs and budget. And here's the best part. Once logs are indexed, they become fully available across dashboards, monitors, and notebooks. This is where the real power of observability kicks in, correlating logs with metrics, alerts, and user impact over time. Let me show you how that works. LiveTail is great, but when you need long-term access, indexing is where you turn. It lets you retain logs for days, weeks, or even months. In the log pipeline alongside LiveTail, you'll find something called indexes. Indexes let you store logs for longer than the default 15-day window. You can also create custom indexes, 3 days, 7 days, 90 days, whatever fits your needs. Retention depends on how valuable the logs are and how far back you might need to investigate. What's great about indexes? You can align log retention with the value and cost of each log type. Error logs might be worth keeping for 15-30 days. Info logs, maybe just 3. Debug logs, possibly even less. When creating a new index, there are a few things to watch. First, name it clearly. A helpful tip, include the retention period in the name. For example, index 3 days makes things easy to track. This makes it easier to filter and identify logs, especially when they're tagged by index name. Let's say I want all logs with status info to go through this index. From here, I set the retention period and define a daily quota. After retention, you set a daily quota. This helps prevent your costs from unexpectedly spiking. Here's a tip. Let the index run for a few days to measure average log volume. Then multiply that average by 3 to set a safe daily quota. That way you won't hit the limit during a critical incident, even if your app suddenly floods logs. You avoid surprise bills from unexpected log surges. Let me walk you through a strategy I've used. Important distinction. Indexes behave differently from pipelines. Pipelines let logs pass through all matching rules, but indexes? Logs only go to the first matching index in order. So if a log doesn't match index A but does match index B, it'll go to B and stop there. Example, if index B stores logs for 15 days, that log goes there and won't get picked up by any later indexes. That's why index order is critical. Here's a strategy I use. For environment equals sign prod and status equals sign error, I store those logs longer. For all other prod logs that aren't errors, I keep them for 15 days. And for everything that doesn't match those filters, I keep it for 15 days, though that's just a fallback. You could drop it to 3 for cost savings. Here's the nuance. Not indexing a log doesn't mean throwing it away. Ingested logs, temporarily searchable, approximately 15 minutes. Indexed logs, stored and searchable over time. Archived logs, saved to cloud storage for long-term on-demand recovery. You can ingest logs for visibility now, archive for later, and index only what you need. It's a powerful combo. So we just looked at how indexing helps you decide what logs to keep and for how long. That's your first level of control. But let's say you've got an index for production logs with a 15-day retention. Do you really need to keep every single line, like debug logs or health checks? Probably not. That's where exclusion filters come in. They let you fine-tune your indexes by removing specific types of logs you don't want to store, even if they match your index rules. Think of it as the cleanup crew. You keep what matters and quietly drop the rest. Let's jump in and see how to set these up. We've already set priorities and retention times. Now let's go deeper. How do we exclude the logs we don't want at all? For example, in the main index, we still get logs from all kinds of sources. This is where we can start adding exclusion filters. Say we want to match all logs with status debug. We can set that filter to exclude 100% of them. You've got total flexibility here, but in most cases, debug logs aren't worth keeping long-term. You could choose to retain them for just 3 days or skip them entirely, like in this example. The best part? Excluding 100% is reversible. If you ever need to index those logs again, just disable the rule. One click and they're back. Indexed like any others? So during normal operations, you can safely exclude these logs to stay lean. Then when you hit a debugging session, you simply re-enable the rule and start capturing again. You can create exclusion filters for just about anything, specific services, clusters, environments, and more. As a best practice, I recommend adding at least one exclusion rule per index, so you're only keeping what's valuable. Here's the big idea behind logging without limits. Every log has a cost, and not all logs have equal value. Make sure the cost you assign to each log reflects its value to you, and that value might change over time. In troubleshooting mode, certain logs are priceless. But day-to-day, you can often drop them to keep things clean. That's where exclusion filters shine. You can manage all of this dynamically via the API. That means you can automatically switch logging rules based on your environment or situation. Whether to index or exclude can shift automatically, based on what's happening. But while logs give granular detail, they're not ideal for long-term trend tracking. That's where metrics from logs come in. You can generate a custom metric from a log field and keep it for 15 months or more. Quick warning, avoid high cardinality metrics like per user or per customer. Stick to aggregated fields like service, status, or environment. For example, from Nginx logs, you can track status code counts as a metric. Now you can track error rates without storing every log. But let's get down to a quick demo. Back to logging without limits. Those ingested logs are now structured through pipelines and processes. There's one more piece we haven't explored, generating metrics from logs. Instead of keeping every log line, you can retain the insights, not the noise. For example, we can generate a metric that captures the duration of logs from a specific service, like Vector. You can view these as a distribution. Or count how many logs came in with a status debug tag from your service. Instead of filtering blindly, I can pull logs from service ABC and break them down by status, info, error, debug, and so on. Now I've got a metric that shows counts for each status type, info, error, debug. I can use that to run analytics and quickly spot trends like spikes in error rates, all without storing every log line. No indexing needed, this metric exists independently of your log storage. You're looking for high-level signals that represent behavior patterns, without drowning in raw data. Here's the kicker, there's no sampling involved. And since metrics are stored for 15 months, you can track trends long-term, all without needing to store the original logs for months. Now let's shift to archiving, your long-term safety net. In Datadog, you can send logs to S3 or blob storage. Why is this useful? Because you avoid over-indexing and reduce your storage costs. You still retain all logs for audits, investigations, or compliance checks. And if needed, you can rehydrate them straight back into Datadog. Pro tip, give each team its own archive bucket. It keeps ownership clean and makes cost tracking easier. So how does it work? Let's walk through the last major piece of logging without limits, log forwarding to archives. You can access this by clicking into Forwarding, Archives in the Datadog UI. From here, you can forward all incoming logs to external cloud storage, Amazon S3, GCP, or Azure for long-term retention. Logs are stored in zip files, readable by external tools like Amazon Athena, even without Datadog. But the real power, you can rehydrate those logs anytime. Archiving gives you rehydration. If you didn't index something and need it later, you can bring those logs back into Datadog. Rehydrated logs regain full functionality. You can search, analyze, and visualize them like any indexed log, even if those logs weren't indexed originally. It's perfect for troubleshooting root causes and understanding exactly what happened. But it's also critical for compliance and security, like reviewing activity from 6 months ago, or even a full year back, whether you indexed the logs at the time or not. Because it's stored in S3 or a similar archive bucket, you stay in full control of the storage and cost. Want to keep logs for 6 months, a year, or even 5 years? You can move them to Glacier or any cold storage you like. I now thought on archives. They let you tighten your index and exclusion rules without the fear of losing data. This means you can save on indexing costs day after day because you know your logs are safely archived. Safe and sound. Your logs are there if you ever need to pull them back. Creating an archive is simple, especially if AWS is already connected to your Datadog account. Just click New Archive, give it a name, and set a filter. That's it. You're ready to store logs at scale. Now, you might want one for production and one for development, so you have different sets of S3 buckets organized by potential scope of rehydration. To make the rehydration successful, you first need to know in which archive the logs are and make sure that the scan size is not crazy high. So when organizing your archive, think about those criteria first to make the user experience during rehydration the best possible. All right, we've now covered all the core pillars of logging without limits. Indexing, archiving, exclusions, LiveTail, and more. You've now got the full toolkit, but there's one last feature you should know about, custom destinations. This is your go-to option when you want to send logs somewhere else, outside of Datadog indexing or archiving. Maybe you want to push logs to a different cloud provider, a third-party analytics tool, or a specialized storage system. Whether it's for compliance, advanced analysis, or just organizational needs, custom destinations give you total flexibility. Let me show you how it works. In the second part of log forwarding, you'll find custom destinations. Yes, it still ties into logging without limits. But here, the goal isn't cost control. It's about directing logs to where they're needed most, securely and efficiently. You can send all logs or just a specific subset. Need to route logs to a SIM tool, a partner system, or for deeper analysis? Security monitoring, external teams, or audit partners. It all works and all your logs are already parsed. Just set up a data forwarder. No code changes required. It's all handled from the Datadog UI. And that's a full tour of logging without limits in Datadog. We started with LiveTail, giving you real-time visibility without the cost of indexing. Then we explored indexing strategies, showing how to keep high-value logs longer and trim the rest. We added exclusion filters to fine-tune retention, used archives to safely store everything off-platform, and built metrics from logs to track long-term trends without bloating your bill. And finally, we looked at custom destinations for when your logs need to go beyond Datadog. Together, these tools give you a powerful framework to scale your observability without scaling your costs. You're not just storing logs anymore, you're managing them strategically based on value. If this was helpful, give the video a like, subscribe for more deep dives, and leave a comment if you have questions or want to share your own logging strategy. In the next video, I'll show you how to apply this consistently in a real-world setup. Until then, stay efficient, stay observant, and don't let your logs control you. As always, happy monitoring.